Hello friends, I'm Imran Sayed. In our last video, we had seen how to download a PLC software and how to install it. So we had downloaded a software for our Delta PLC. The name of the software was WPLsoft 2.49. Today we are going to use the same software to start with our first ladder diagram program. Well, to do that, we'll click on the icon for WPLsoft 2.48. So the software is opening. And now, before we begin, let me tell you, we are not going to connect anything to the PLC. There are no physical connections with the PLC. Rather, we will be using a simulator. The reason behind that is, once you execute your program precisely in your simulator, and once you are convinced that the program is working fine, then you could actually go ahead and make the physical connections with the PLC. That is, the input connected to the input side, output connected to the output side, and the program could be loaded in PLC. However, today we are going to do that on simulator. So to begin, now that we have opened the software, we'll click on File and we'll click on New. Here it is asking me for a name, so I'll write a name, ABCD. You could write in any name. And then it is asking me for model type. The model obviously is PLC. However, under select, it is asking me the series. Because we are not using any PLC physically, so whatever default appears in the drop-down menu, you could keep it as it is. Then file name, again, you could give whatever name you want. So I can type in my name. So I'll type it. And then I'll click on OK. So this is what appears on the screen. Now I want to use this is my usable space. So I want to make it wide open. So I'll double click on the blue line. So this is how it appears. This is the cursor. I can keep moving it. Now let me place the cursor from where I want to start the PLC program or the ladder diagram. So I'll place it here, right in the left hand side corner. Now let me explain you. What the PLC program is going to be all about, what this ladder diagram is going to be all about. This ladder diagram, I'm going to use a switch and an output device. A normally open contact of a switch and one output device. In PLC, that is Delta PLC, the inputs are denoted as X0, and the output is denoted as Y. So, where do I get the normally open contact of a switch? So in this taskbar over here, this is a normally open contact. So I can click on it. The moment I do that, a window pops up and the device name is pre-written as X. Because I had selected an open contact and contacts are for input side, so the default name has come as X. And the device number has come as 0. Now, am I supposed to take only 0 or can I take some other number? So the answer is yes, I can take some other number. It will always be dependent on where you have connected the switch on your PLC. Right now, since we are not using a PLC and we are using a simulator, so you could take any number. Here it is 0. I can make it as 1, 2, 3, whatever I want. Below, it has given me a range, that is X0 to X377. Now the next question is, is this range applicable for all PLCs? And the answer is no. Depending upon the number of inputs your PLC has, you will have the range. For example, if you are using a PLC which has only 16 inputs, so the range would be from X0 to X15. Right now, when I was using the simulator, the model that I had selected or the default type which will appear on the screen was SV2. So that particular model could accommodate 378 inputs, and so the range is X0 to X377. So now I have taken X4 as the input. I can give any name to that. I can write it as switch and I'll click on OK. So the X4 appears here. If I highlight it, if I keep my cursor here, it shows switch. Then now the open contact, it is called open because there are two lines and they do not touch each other. So it is an open contact. Now I'll have to select an output device. So where is the output device? It reads as F7. That's the shape of a coil. it looks like a bracket. So I'll click. Now, wherever I placed my cursor, the output device is actually connected there. So there it goes. Since I said the output is denoted Y, so it appears as Y. Again, the default number is 0. I could increase it to whatever I want. So I've taken it as Y4. I could keep it as 3, 2, whatever I want. It has given me a range. So I could use any number from that range. I can write a name to that or a comment to that. I'll write lamp and I'll click on OK. So if you see, the input is over here and the output has automatically gone to extreme right. What is the reason behind that? Well, in your ladder diagram, the line which is to your left is called as left rail. And there's one more line to the right which is not visible, and that is called as right rail. And the line which is placed horizontally between the left rail and right rail is called as rung. So whatever contacts of input you place or the output you place is going to be between the left rail and right rail on the horizontal line, which is called as rung. As in, when you place this contact on the horizontal line, you should make sure that there is only one output contact in one rung. You can have as many number of inputs as you want on one rung. However, the output contact should always be one. So in this case, since we have used only one input, so there is one input and there's one output. The input is always to the left side of the output. So let me repeat, you can have as many number of inputs as you want, which are connected in series or parallel in one rung. However, every rung can have only one output, and that output is always placed to extreme right. Also, let me tell you, the left rail is connected internally to a positive supply and the right rail is connected to ground. So whenever you operate the switches or sensors which are connected to the left hand side, the current would move from left to right. It will pass through the load and get grounded. That is how the circuit gets complete. Now, to go ahead with the program, since the program is already written, we need to compile it. Now, to compile the program, we need to click on compiler and blender instruction. So the compiler has compiled the program, and that's the reason it writes as end. Once the program is compiled, now that we are going to use simulator, so we need to activate the simulator first. So to do that, I have to go here and I have to click on it. So there it is, a simulator has popped up at the bottom. Now this program, whatever we have done, is in laptop, but we need to send it to PLC. We don't have a physical PLC, but since we have started the simulator, so we have to simulate the process of sending the program to PLC. To do that, I'll have to click on online, which says that we are sending this program, the program which is already compiled. By clicking on online mode, we are sending it or we are downloading it to the PLC. So I'll click on it. It tells me the program is not consistent with PLC, which means it is not there in the PLC. Do you want to download the current opened program to PLC? The answer is yes. So now those blue lines indicated that the program is downloaded in the PLC. However, the stop at the bottom says that the PLC is in stop mode, so we got to place it in run mode. To do that, we'll have to click on run. Then you have to click on yes. So now the PLC is in run mode. So how do I function now? Because there is no physical switch, so we'll have to make some changes in the program. How do we do that? The PLC is already in run mode and in simulation. So now let's click on export. The blue line shows that it is selected. I'll right click on it and then say set on. The moment I click on set on, the output device Y2 will also turn on. Let's see how does that happen. So set on, the X4 will appear to be green, and so will the output device Y2. Let's see. There it is. The X4 looks green, which was white initially. White meant that it is open, and Y2, which was also white, has now appeared to be green. So the moment the green appears on the input side, it indicates that you have changed the position of the switch. So from open, it has gone closed. Because it was closed, so the load, that is the lamp, has received the supply and it appears to be green, which indicates that it is on. Now, if I wish to turn it off, I can again go back, right click on it and say off. Now you see the color has changed again. Again, I can click right click on it and say set on. So it has turned on again. So friends, that was our first ladder diagram program on PLC. I hope that you people have understood the same. Now, in order to stop this, we'll have to click on stop. That gets the PLC in stop mode, and it is still in the simulation mode, so you could click on the simulator to come out of the simulator mode. If at all you feel that whatever you've done is precise in the program and your program gives you desired result, then you could go ahead and physically connect the PLC and download the same program by connecting the PLC to the laptop. Well, for now, if you wish to make any changes, now you could make it, right? So that's it, friends. That was all from my end. That was our first program on PLC. I hope you guys have understood. Thank you.